morning. Good morning.
Morning.
Well, much better, but I think you can do it better. Good morning.
Morning.
So, nice meeting you. I'm doing the technical part, then Robert will join me, and afterwards Rasmus will join me and take over. So the first technical thing is that here in these rooms is absolutely no smoking, not inside the building, not even at the social event. Please take care and smoke outside. There are some facilities. You already might have found them. So to me, everybody says, hey, Jürgen is doing the conference, but as every year, this is plain wrong, because I have a lot of people that help me, and I just want to say really thank you to Sandra Krieg. Without her, simply this conference wouldn't exist. And Daniel Lienert, who is programming all my ideas that I have to make this conference even easier. So to me, it would be great if we can get a hand. Yeah. So this year, I had the pleasure to work with the design team. My contact was Robert Zierhofer, and it was really smooth working with them. It was great this year. It took a lot of, they took a lot of pressure from me working on it. Some things needed to be smoothed out, but there's always improvement chances. So I really want to say thank you to the design team as well. And to the website team, this is the first time that we did this conference website with Flow 3, which was an interesting experience. it was a great experience after all, and after the website is online and everything is running and smooth, but in between we had some discussions, heated discussions, I would say, but it was really cool that we did it, and it gave some push to the Flow 3 team, that's what I heard, and this is what it was made for. So I think it was worth the discussions, and I want to say thank you to the website team as well. Last but not least, this whole conference wouldn't exist with all our sponsors, and I first want to thank all the platinum sponsors we have, which is DKD. Drehcom, Mittwald Medien, and the Domain Factory. I really want to say thank you to them, and they are all of them there, not for the first time, not for the second time, but I think most of them are there for the third time, which is great. But maybe other agencies or other companies that are using Title 3 see a chance to help us next year, so we might have 5, 6, or 7 sponsors. All the money that we get goes into the Title 3 project and will help the development. So all the platinum sponsors also have a chance to do a so-called elevator pitch. The idea of an elevator pitch, I introduce it a little bit. The idea is that you go into an elevator, the door closes, and the last thing happens is that Bill Gates jumps in, stands next to you, you see him, and you say, hey, that's cool, Bill Gates, we have now 20 seconds, I can tell you my great story, why you should work with my company, and this is the chance the platinum sponsors are having now. We start with DKD. Hi. So.
Hello, good morning. Yeah, DKD is an owner-managed full-service internet agency located in Frankfurt, Germany. We are specialized in development, communications, and design. Our team consists of over 40 salaried employees. We have a great time of experience, which is over 12 years now. And in this time, we realized over 350 successful projects with Title 3 and with other open source tools, and over 100 satisfied clients are happy to be with us. But we want you, since you are here, and we are always looking for talented people. So if you are a Type 3 developer, a Java developer, HTML, CSS developer, Unix, Linux administrator, or an art director, just come to our booth, talk to us, and get on board. And of course, we love Type 3, and that's why we're happy to welcome you at our booth right in front of the door. Talk to us, meet the DKD speakers who have talks here at the conference, and bid on 5 Reverend Neverend limited edition special t-shirts. They are tie-dyed, oh, this word is great. And you can bid on them at our booth, you can bid on them via Twitter, and you can bid on them via Facebook. And maybe there's another secret way you will surely find out how to do that. So enjoy the conference, thank you very much, have a great time.
Thank you. Thank you, Søren.
So next company that can introduce herself is Drecom, and I hand the mic over.
Okay, thank you. Do it this way. Just one slide.
I can hold it for you.
No, I can't.
Okay.
Thank you. Well, welcome to everybody. My name is Greco Steenmetz. I'm from Drecom. Very proud to be here because Type 3 is very important to us. And well, they call this minute, this elevator pitch, also 1 minute of fame. And well, it's brought to you by Drecom, and we have about the same company as you just saw for DKD, about the same size. But the fame today, in this 1 minute of fame, goes to Type 3, because Type 3 is our future, is our present, and is our past. And we do this for a long time. We use it for more than 10 years. And why? Because Type 3 is big. It's big for us, and I think it's big for everybody here. It helps us develop great sites for great customers, for especially the bigger customers. Yeah, that's why Type 3 is big for us. It makes big ideas possible. Not a site, we can build every site with Type 3. And well, it's continuously improving, it's getting bigger, it's getting better. And that's thanks to the big community, to all of you, to the Type 3 Association, which is getting better and bigger. We believe in Type 3. It's in good times and in bad times. But that's why we continue to invest in Type 3. We continue to invest in experts, in certified experts. And that's why we want to contribute, continue to contribute to Type 3 in all ways, doing sponsoring, but also contributing to development and, of course, in other community efforts. The big fame today is for Type 3, and I want to ask for a big applause for Type 3.
So we have 2 more Platinum sponsors, which are not taking the chance to stand up here. So it's, again, Mittwald Medien, I want to thank for them, and the Domain Factory. So now we are coming to the gold sponsors, and I think everybody knows him and loves him. It's Jochen Weiland from jochenweiland.net, and I really appreciate I really appreciate all the support that he not only does by money-wise, but also supports us with his questions. So, which is true, I really like it. We have some, this is not right, this is not gold sponsors, they are bronze sponsors from Möller-Hörcher. They are doing the PR for this conference. And from Meteos, and I want to say thank you to them as well. So, last year we had the 3rd conference in the United States, which is great. And I did some promises to them and didn't keep it, although it was in San Francisco. And this year we won't have a conference in the United States, but we will have a conference in Canada, in Quebec, which is, as I'm told, a French-speaking country. And one of the organizers is here. It's Patrick Gaumont. And I would like you, if you are French-speaking, they will have a French-speaking track for the French community there. And he is looking out here for French speakers joining this conference. And the rest of you, I would be happy to see them there on June 13th till the 15th. That's Wednesday to Friday in Quebec, in Canada. And I hope that it will be as nice as we had all the times in San Francisco together. Okay, so one of the last things one of the things we have at the conference is the Best Paper Award for all the speakers that put in an awful lot of time in preparing their slides, even last minute. And it would be great if you visited the talk, then you can vote for this talk and give him a star rating where 5 stars is best and 1 star is worst. So if you like a talk, then you should go to the conference website and you find it under Sessions, which is here, and then on the first line is Best Paper Award, or you just memorize this nice fancy URL. So you log in with your ticket number, which you have here down below the barcode. And at the end of the conference, all the speakers, or the first 3 speakers, will get a gift depending on how many votes they got or how many stars they are rated. So it would be great if you help us. You can do it after any talk you visited. The VLAN is there, maybe you already logged in and can do the voting for this. So the conference ending, I already talked about it. As you might have noticed, is that everybody gets some stuff you can grab, and we have this open till 4 p.m. on Saturday, so please collect your stuff before 4 p.m. We have some nice Type 3 logo USB sticks for you, and a t-shirt as always, and it would be great if you just grab your stuff or your gear until 4 p.m. And this time we have to close the rooms directly after the official ending. So a nice get together could be outside there in the town. If you visit, go there with some friends. And it would help if you really grab your stuff and can leave at 5 p.m. As always, we have some last minute changes. This year there are more than in the 7 years before, I think, or the 6 years before. One change is easy. They're already online on the website. On the website, the schedule is fine. So if I forget something to say, the website schedule is the one you should go for. So maybe if you have some tracks you want to go for, check it on the website, and then you see where it is and if it happens at all. The first one is just a switch. Today, on the schedule, the talk, the one thing to list everything, and the Type 3 photo gallery management with Jack, they just swapped the talks. So it's the same rooms, everything, but the talks are swapped, that's all. Yesterday, Mats Brunn informed me that he can't make it because he is ill, and for this reason, we had to cancel his talk. As it was parallel to Robots Flow 3 talk, it might be the best choice, so then you can visit, because I expect that talk to be full. So, and this was the reason. This morning, I heard that another speaker is ill, so it seems there's something going on in the Type 3 community. I don't know what. Maybe they were together somewhere. Renz Admiral won't make it, so the one talk, Lazy Development Using the Extension Builder, is what we needed to cancel. But the other talk, the content templates and the rich user interface in Type 3, we have a new speaker who prepared it with Renz, and Greco Steinmetz will give this talk for him. So the time and the room will stay the same, but we have a different speaker there. The first one, lazy development, won't happen. And then one last thing, you might all have already noticed it. Again, on that flyer, there's one bug. The Flow 3 and Type 3 Phoenix in a real-world debut today, on Friday, 1400 to 1445, is double, because the talk also, we put them in by accident on tomorrow. The talk today, Flow 3 and Type 3 Phoenix development, is canceled. You find it on the fourth track here. It's the first one in the evening, but this is canceled, and it will be given tomorrow. So it's not twice there, it's just canceled today. But again, on the website, everything is fine and correct, as we have a great content management system. Okay, so that's from my side. I hand it now over to Robert, who will tell more about things.
Firing chain is armed, sound suppression water system activated. T-minus 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. Go for main engine start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0, and liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis, reaching the crest of its historic achievements in space.
Houston, Atlantis is in a roll.
Roger, roll.
Houston is now controlling. The roll maneuver is complete. Atlantis is in a heads-down position on course for a 51.6 degree, 136 by 36 statute mile orbit. And the three main engines on Atlantis have now been throttled down to 72% of rated thrust. As the orbiter prepares to pass through the area of maximum dynamic pressure on the vehicle in the lower atmosphere.
So, welcome. I wanted to share this with you today, because this, what I'm going to talk about, is about something we didn't plan for, and something which we didn't think was possible. So that is the connection to what I've just shown you. That is not really what someone has imagined would be possible back then, launching a rocket and actually landing on the moon. So I think we have something to celebrate today, and I'm really happy that we are here in this great location. I mean, when I arrived here in Hanau, I was a bit reluctant. But this conference center is really awesome. We spent a whole day for the tutorial yesterday, and it's just really professional here. It is a very nice, inspiring location. Unfortunately, the weather is more like, you should visit all the talks, of course, and not stay so much outside. So, yeah, we have something to celebrate today, a milestone. And before we come to that, I'd like to recap a bit what happened since the last year. I certainly won't be able to tell you everything because a lot of things happened. But in the version 4 branch, Type 3 has proven that it's still really the most successful content management system in some area of the world. The core team has made a big commitment with the release of version 4.5 with the long-term support, 3 years of support. And this was really appreciated by a lot of users, by a lot of agencies. Magazines reported about it because this is something unique in open source community, which is not backed up by a company, is committing to such a great support. We have a very regular release schedule for version 4 at this moment. And this also makes it very easy to plan ahead. You know when the next version will be there, so you can plan your migrations. And Type 3.4.6 is really right ahead. It's full of new features. Really, a lot of work went into it. And the work on version 4.7 started already with accessibility improvements, nice media management, a lot of things. And also, some quite powerful sponsor was found for this version. So there's really something to be proud of. Personally, when I sit in a train and talk to someone, what are you doing as a job? Then he would tell me, and he'd ask me, and I try to explain that in a very complicated way. I mean, how do you explain like what I'm doing or what you are doing? So I said, yeah, something with internet websites. You know, if you have a big website, you need a system to maintain all the content, like because editors cannot program. And so it's a content management system, but it's not a product we sell. It's actually for free, and I'm working in an open source project. And usually they say something like Type 3. Like, yeah, very similar. Kind of like that. And that happens so many times. During weddings or parties, you sit with random people there. Really, doesn't matter. Somewhere in their company, someone uses Type 3, or in their golf club, they're using Type 3. This is really inspiring. You know that my personal job is working on the next version, and we have an ever-growing team behind that, so I'd like to tell you a bit about what's happening in version 5, Type 3 Phoenix. So there's quite some time we already spent on that. And last year, we could demo you some first impressions of a working user interface. And then at Christmas, we had a great milestone. Actually, we could release some milestone release of Type 3 Phoenix with the new design and the user interface. I created a little video about it, and that was watched more than 7,500 times within the first 2 weeks. And since then has been watched over 25,000 times. So there is apparently quite some interest in what we're doing there, probably not only because everybody's waiting for so long, but also because it's a really exciting topic. So Christmas, we also were able to demo workspaces, the publication process, etc. And then, to the outside, there was a long period where nothing really happened. If you look at our commit log, you see that a lot of code was produced in that time. But we didn't do any sprint releases anymore. And that had two reasons. One thing was, as you know, we're using XJS for the user interface. And XJS is a really great library of widgets, of user interface elements. You have probably seen lots of demos from XJS. You really can do create a desktop application with XJS elements. And that works pretty nice if you don't want to change these components. If you're fine with the default design, if you're fine with the widgets they provide, and there are a lot of widgets, but for the ideas we have for the user interface of Typo3, we needed a few new custom widgets. So Renz, for example, he's really one of the poor guys in our team, not only that he's ill today, but he spent like, I don't know, 50 hours or something on a stupid little animated component, and that was just ridiculous. At that point, we realized this is not realistic, what we're doing there. We're trying to animate something which should take 2-3 hours maybe of work, and we're spending 50-60 hours. So we progressed very, very slowly in the beginning of this year. And the other thing was that we were having some very big refactorings going on in the Flow 3 part, which were necessary. Benjamin Eberlei is probably the reason why things have delayed for almost half a year. So, because we integrated Doctrine, which was a very, very good choice for us, I'll tell you something about that later. So, the whole user interface is produced by the UI team of the Phoenix core team. We have a little group of people who are more capable in JavaScript and HTML, CSS than I am or Carsten is. So, we have some experts working on that. And unfortunately, these guys also have their lives and writing diploma thesis, and so it's not really predictable how much time they can spend on Phoenix. We can pay them for some of that time to do the really dirty work nobody else wants to do, but there's also the amount of time we can buy is also limited, unfortunately. So it was not really predictable how fast we can progress in the UI department. And then at the developer days this year, right after the keynote, Sebastian and Christopher came to me. Do you have a minute? Yeah, I got some 10 minutes until the next talk. We need to talk to you. We want to trash the whole user interface and start from scratch again. I thought, that's a great idea. Because people are not waiting for it. I mean, we have plenty of time. So we discussed that a bit. And eventually, we really did that. We trashed the implementation of the user interface and took another approach. The user interface with XJS is a lot of HTML and markup generated by JavaScript. So basically, you have a template which has 3 lines of HTML, and the rest is done in JavaScript. All the user interface is created by JavaScript. It's a bit like the classic backend in Typo3 3 back then. And this is really hard to style. We are now having a different direction. We are doing progressive enhancement. We have HTML templates based on Fluid, and we enrich them with jQuery and Sprout Core. Sebastian will tell you a lot more about that, but we had a code sprint recently. That's my coffee machine, and it's not at my home, so we had to take my coffee machine with me to accelerate the code sprint. That was a really nice thing we did there. It was really intensive, 9 days in a row. It was pretty exhaustive until 2-3 o'clock late night. But we achieved things which we couldn't do in months before. One of the reasons is really the new architecture we have, the Sprout Core and jQuery and the other techniques. The other thing is, of course, that if you actually can meet and discuss, then you can progress much faster. So this is made possible also by the donators of the Type 3 Association, that we can have meetings like that, that we can rent a room and pay the travel expenses for the guys. Most of the hours were not paid, really. Sebastian was one guy logging his time but not selling it. Was over 90 hours he spent there. So this is really intensive and really cool. Now, we have a nice user interface, and we even have new functions we didn't plan for to do in that sprint. We have image handling you can crop in the user interface, and you should really watch the talk of Sebastian, who will show that. On the left side, you see Renz. He looks a bit sick already at that photo. And Sebastian seems to think, like, how will I do that talk without him? But fortunately, Sebastian does that together with Christian. You should really watch that and see what's possible with Type 3. So that is a bit of a catch-up, what's happening in the Type 3 world currently. And you know that we have this other color as well. We have Flow 3. And Flow 3 is really important for Type 3. Because if you look at what a CMS consists of, a lot of that is actual infrastructural code, which has to do with security, with user management, with package management, templating, logging, all these things. So if you would analyze Type 3 today, Type 3, 4, you would see that only a small part of it is actually dealing with content management. And all that part which is not dealing with content management, this is in Flow 3. So Flow 3 is very important for Type 3 Phoenix. But the question is, we have created a new product out of it to share it with the PHP community because we think it's so useful. But what is so unique about Flow 3? There are other frameworks, of course. For us, as Type 3 users, Flow 3 is very unique and helpful because you now have a framework which is compatible with a CMS. Previously, when we started with Type 3, we were developing websites, lots of content management. And over the time, we're doing more and more projects where customers demand applications. So we're using our CMS to create applications. But sometimes a true application framework would be the better fit. So you choose an application framework. If you choose Flow 3, your code is 100% compatible with a CMS. So you can reuse your code as a plugin in Type 3 Phoenix. And you can also go the other way around. You just create a website, use the plugins, and say, I don't need that content management anymore. I create a standalone application with Flow 3. So Flow 3 is really independent from Type 3. You can just use it as just another framework instead of some other established frameworks, but you also can use it in combination with Flow 3. We also have a bit a different approach about the quality and the style of coding. Christopher said his tagline is that, or his when he is about to explain what Flow 3 is so special, makes it so special, is that it enables you to create excellent software. This is one part of our mission statement in Type 3, to jointly innovate excellent free software. Because Flow 3 doesn't only help you creating software in a very easy way, it also teaches you the best practices of real software engineering, and takes a very pragmatic approach because, after all, it's PHP and not Java. Yeah. When I've been in San Francisco, there was one guy joining us, Jess Humble from ThoughtWorks. The guys I read a book about continuous delivery. Was really awesome that he talked at the conference in San Francisco for us. And he looked at Flow 3, and he started PHP development. But after all, in ThoughtWorks is a huge consulting company. They're doing Java, C#, etc. So he looked at the Flow 3 code and said, "That looks like a Java application, but without all the crap." So he found it very capable. And if you compare it with other frameworks, especially in the PHP universe, you might rather call Flow 3 a web application platform, because other frameworks are mostly component libraries. And the advantage of a component library is that all its parts are very independent from each other. You can just choose any of them, mix them, and create your own application. You have a lot of choices. You can use different configuration formats. You have XML, YAML, INI, for example, in Symfony. You can really choose what you would like to do. Flow 3 is a very opinionated framework. So we don't give you that many choices. We give you an overall concept. We have a certain idea of how you should write an application, and you can leave that path, but it will not be as nice as following the conventions we provide. So instead of only delivering the software, we are also delivering and developing the whole ecosystem and the related techniques. We know that once you created a Flow 3 application, you want to deploy it on a server. And we thought about how you can do that. We thought about how you can deploy that on 20 web servers simultaneously. We thought about how you can deploy Flow 3 applications in a cloud environment with content delivery networks. We practice techniques how to improve the quality of code by code reviews and a certain continuous integration flow. And this is what we bring into the community, so you can use that in your agency as well. I know that lots of these techniques we deliver are really new to lots of you. And some of you might think that this is really complicated. And I have to confess that Flow 3 is really rocket science. But in a good way. I was not sure if it makes sense to present a code example to you. But who's a developer of you somehow? There are lots of developers, so it might make sense and you feel at home. This is just one example what we have in Flow 3. We have dependency injection. Some other frameworks also have dependency injection. Just recently, Zen Framework also started having dependency injection. And they start there where we left a few years ago, after we made certain experiences with that. What you see here is some use of property injection, which is unique to Flow 3. But so you want to instantiate a new customer class. And you want to be sure that this class has access to a customer number generator service. So we use dependency injection for that. You see that inject annotation up there. It tells the framework, make sure that this variable here contains a customer number generator object. So far, so good. There are ways to program that. But the problem is this. You create a new customer. So this is your class, your customer class. And the second line is already using this new customer. And at that point in time, you already have to have the customer number generator injected into the customer object. Tell that to your customer. So if you're a bit into programming, you see that there's a problem. How can the framework write that code in the middle, like inject customer number generator? There's no way how it can do that, because you instantiate the new class and then you call the code right away afterwards. But we found a way to do to solve that. It took 4 months of coding, actually. We are using some proxy classes, code generation, compiling steps, which you don't realize because it's happening in the background. But it's possible. And you might ask yourself, why do we need that if it's so much work? Because it enables you to use third-party code, for example. It potentially, you can just use a Symfony component or Zen Framework component and just use it as a package in Flow 3. Because this code, for example, in Zen Framework, they usually have new operators. And so you don't want to rewrite that code. So now it becomes compatible with Flow 3, and you can use all the techniques like aspect-oriented programming, etc., on this new code. So from our side, Flow 3 is really rocket science in terms of solving problems, because they tend to be very complex. But we chose to rather solve one problem once and for all than you, when you're using Flow 3, have to solve it a million times again and again. So if you look at Flow 3 code yesterday at the tutorial, an action controller consists of like 10 lines of PHP code, and the rest is done by Flow 3 in a very foreseeable and not so magic way. So we would like that developers using Flow 3 have it very simple. They just use Flow 3 and let it do what they think is important. And after all, for a user, Flow 3 is not really rocket science. It's extremely simple to learn. And I have the opinion that learning Flow 3 is even easier for those who are completely new to PHP than those who have been using PHP for several years, because it's much harder to forget all the coding practices you had in your past than learning something new. Right, we have delivered 15 alpha versions of Flow 3 and 3 beta versions if we are going to release another beta version. So the question is, when will there finally be a final stable 1.0 release? And I'd like to mention one blog post from Matt Mullenweg, the founder of WordPress. He wrote a very nice article worth reading in his blog, 1.0 is a lonely number. And he tells about Steve Jobs, and that's an old blog post. It's not about yesterday or something. Steve Jobs, when he presented the first version of the iPhone, everybody was laughing, like, this doesn't even have an app store. It doesn't have copy and paste. It's lacking so many obvious features. And at that time, probably, Steve Jobs already had the third generation of the iPhone in his pocket. They were, of course, they already knew that they would have all these features. They probably, the copy and paste team was just about to finish it, but it couldn't get into the first release. So releasing a 1.0 release is really hard because you have so many ideas what else you want to put into that release. But you better do that early. And now that we have actual projects which are based on Flow 3, big customer projects, and you can see watch one of these talks, you see there's some real-world experience with Flow 3 talks. We think it's time to release Flow 3.1.0, and it's right after the conference on October 20th, and we'll release Flow 3.1.0 after 5 years of work. So about that lonely number, we know already that Flow 3.1.0 is not as fast as we would like to have. We already have profiling in place where we know these parts we will improve. But for the projects using Flow 3, it's good enough. They are happy with it. It's stable enough. So this will be something for the 1.1 release, just if you wonder. Then some people asked, so how do we continue with Flow 3? Now that it's out, it needs some PR. We need to do lots of marketing and spread the word. But the point is, we are an open source community. We don't sell licenses. It's not important that we sell 1,000 Flow 3 licenses in the first 2 days or something. We don't really need that marketing. We appreciate all the attention we get. And I like that we have several interviews this time. They're interested in these topics. But what we really need is happy users. So our commitment is that we concentrate on the first users we have. The first 300 users get some very special attention, some fast lane support in the core team. We want to make them happy because those developers are the right ones. They already are skilled enough to use Flow 3, so they will spread the word to others who are similar developers. And that will be the right ones. Okay. I talked a lot about Flow 3 now, and I hope that you enjoy it as much as we do. Earlier this year, I realized that I have my 10th anniversary in this Type 3 community. So that up there, that is Casper's podcast number 3, with some mocked connection. We actually don't see each other. We have our old Hi8. No, it was DVCam quarters, and we had to send the tape by snail mail so he could create the podcast. And at the right side, you see Type 3 version 2.3, if I'm right. The Copenhagen Gospel Festival 1999, or 98, I think. Yeah. And down below, you see the first snowboard tour. So apparently, there's something which kept me in the community, and many others. There are many others, even in this room, who have their 10th anniversary. And the question is, what is that? I never stayed in an open source community that long. Something makes me tick, something keeps me here, and that's not the code, because that's something I could do on my own, probably, I don't know. So what makes you staying here? Why are you here? Is it because your boss sent you here? Who's only here because his boss said, go? So some years ago, we wanted to take this identity of the community and distill it and put it into a brand. And the result was the new logo and some other visual aspects, but also values. That makes our brand. And the brand is much more than just a design. It's much more than some text or a website. It's a lot about values and the spirit. So when you're using our brand, pay close attention to how you're using it. Take care of it. Because After all, the brand is not just some design rules, but it's our identity. So this would be what I would ask you for to take care of the brand. And now Rasmus will talk to you about the spirit and the soul of Type 3, and he's our Mr. Brand. So welcome, Rasmus Gjoldan. Just a second.
Well, hello everyone. It seems I'm going to ask the same question as Robert just asked you. So, but I do think it's a very important question. And thank you. So I was thinking about this before coming here. I was thinking about it actually a couple of months ago. So I was thinking, should I go to the conference to feel cool, or to make money, or to gain power in some way? And obviously that's not really the reason for being here. So I thought, okay, it's a conference, it's about learning stuff, and yeah, it's also about learning, that's right. But I really do feel that we're also here for something else. And that is, as Robert also stated, that we actually care for Type 3 and that we care for each other. So I would like for everyone to think about that, about why you're actually here. I've been involved in Type 3 since 2005. I led the design team for about 4 years. I managed the redesign of the logo years ago. And then a couple of years ago, I tried to tackle a big project for Type 3, which was the relaunch of Type3.org, which appeared to be completely impossible for me to manage. I'm very happy to see that someone else took over and that it's finally nearing a real launch, which is really nice to see. But then some months ago at the developer days, I kind of rediscovered Type 3, entered the Type 3 sphere again. And it was such an amazing experience for me to be at the developer days because something has really changed. Since the last time I was involved in Type 3. And the best way for me to tell this is during the process of building a new brand book, which I'm doing at the moment, I did a survey. Some of you may have answered it, some of you may have seen it. And one of the questions was, how do you feel about Type 3? Which is a pretty stupid question, but I was really interested in seeing the answers that I would get. And what really kind of shocked me was that a lot of people answered that it was truly important to their lives. And that's not just a small thing, I think. It's pretty crazy, actually, that we sit here, it's a CMS, it's open source and everything, and a lot of people answering this survey said that this is really important to my life. We have to remember that. So, what had changed for me, or when I looked upon the Type 3 community again after 2 years of kind of staying out of it, was that there was a lot of pride and there was a lot of generosity. It's always been embedded into the culture of Type 3, but it had somehow been strengthened. And this was really a really profound, great experience for me at the developer days. So, I think we should always really be proud of that. So, and then this small statement here. Sometimes when I talk with people about Type 3, there's this other CMS which is mentioned at times, and then you guess you know what the name is. And huh? Yeah. No. But at times I feel that we're kind of falling into the trap of the ugly duckling story. That we're saying, ah, yeah, if only people knew how cool Type 3 actually is, then everything would be much better, and then they would understand that it's much better than this other CMS. So, I don't believe that's true at all, and I think we just need to remember that this is a world-class, open-source CMS, and we should really be proud of that. So, I think we need to embrace this simple fact that Type 3 can play a very real role in the world today. It's about distributing information, about helping people to communicate. And while we're here, we think a lot about technical matters, and I, on the other hand, come here as the brand guy and thinking about all kinds of other things. And I think it's important to remember this fact that building a CMS is about this. It's about actually helping people communicate and distribute information, which is not a small thing. So, that'll be the end and of my small speech here. I wish you all a very nice conference, and I really look forward to talking to you. And I'll be doing a talk on some of this and the branding issue a little later today. So, welcome.
May now stand up and leave. Have a lot of fun. I'll help you with some music.